Pratik is asking, what is this thing called boredom? Why is life really not interesting? Even when there is a period of interest, why does it fade away? Why does it fade away? Pratik, boredom comes because you are somewhere else. Boredom comes because you are somewhere else. All the fun is here, right now. But you are missing in the action. It's like a great party that's booming here, right now, and you are somewhere else. The party is real. The place where you are is imaginary. You're missing out on all the fun, on all the celebration. His question will be, sir, but if I know that there's a party going on, why would I miss it? Right? If I really know that there is this great feast here, who wants to skip it? Yes, nobody wants to skip it. The thing with this is, Pratik, we have been trained and educated, conditioned thoroughly to live in the future. Especially as a young man, our education and upbringing is all about looking towards the future. Let me give you a few examples from our own life. We study for the sake of results. And results are in the future. Now, as you are sitting with your book, go into it. What really matters to you? The book or the result? The real thing. You are with the book only so that you realize that. Correct? Now, when the result is the real thing, and the result is in the future. When the result is the real thing, what will happen to the quality of life right now? When you are always looking there, this will automatically become boring. Now assume you have something splendid coming your way at 4 p.m. today evening. It's not yet come, but you're imagining it to come, right? It's not yet real, but it's a thought in the mind. This session would not be able to give you anything, because your mind would constantly be there. Are you getting it? You would just be somehow passing this time in order to reach that 4 p.m. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you are in the campus just for the sake of a job and a degree, a recognition, then the real thing would happen in the fourth year. Right? Because that's what you are here for. To get a degree and a job. And right now we are in the... which year?
First year.
Oh, that's too bad. That's too bad. Wish we could just skip everything and move to the fourth year. Can't we have a system where the university admits us directly into the fourth year? Wouldn't it be great? Why pass through these three unnecessary years? After all, the real thing is going to happen in the fourth year, right? So why pass through these three wasteful years? Obviously, the quality of my 4 years would be poor. Because I'll study so as to get marks. I'll come to college just to maintain attendance. I'll enter the classroom just because I want to pass that course. I would always have an eye on proxies. Right? Now how can life be interesting, Prateek? How can life be interesting when in your mind you have pegged the real thing there, fourth year? And I'm not talking only of this infatuation with job and degree. In every other way, it has been taught to us to be result-centric, to be future-centric. And we see it all around us. People are working for the sake of the future. And it's quite puzzling. You must ask, sir, you are living in the present and you are occupied with the future. Life is right now. What is happening to your life, really? The future is not yet there. The future is an imagination, right? For the sake of the imagination, what are you doing to reality? What are you doing to reality? But then, because we see everybody doing this, we don't ask this question. Prateek, you know what do? We think that this is the norm. We think that life must be like this. If everybody is doing something, not everybody can be wrong. As they used to say in China a while back. And they would say it with great pride. 1 billion Chinese cannot be wrong. China was the first country to hit that 1 billion mark. And they would say it with great pride. 1 billion Chinese cannot be wrong. You look at the mentality. What are they saying? Yes, they are saying that everybody is doing this. 1 billion people. How can it be wrong? And that's what we also think. Because everybody is doing it. The newspapers are full of it. The media is full of it. Our family is the entire society, the education system, corporates. It's happening everywhere. Everybody is living in future. Then we say, forget about the 1 billion Chinese. 7 billion people cannot be wrong. The entire population of Earth is living this way. How can it be wrong? No, not really. You see, truth does not depend upon the majority opinion, does it? If the entire Earth declares today that gravity is not 9.8 meter per second square, it passes a resolution that we'll have gravity at 11.8 meters per second square. Let all 7 billion people without exception say this. Would that have any difference upon gravity? So truth is not really a democratic thing. Truth cannot be decided through votes or through majority opinion, right? Be not bothered at all with what everybody is doing and saying. You are fully grown up now. You must be 18 or 20 by now, right? Utilize your own intelligence. And there is great fun in that, right? And such great freedom. And you would smile. When you would really look at the world with your own eyes, you would really have good fun. Good fun, I assure you. When you see all this stupidity going around, it's very, very funny. And you are standing outside of it. It's like watching a circus. And all these jokers, they are performing their comic tricks. And you are watching it. And you are smiling. What do you want? To become a part of that pack of jokers? Or to watch it and have fun? Watch it. Have fun. Be here. Right?